never been introduced with drum beats before. That sounded a little ominous. Good evening. I'm Tehsin Mozaffar. As Lale said, I'm not very far from here. I'm about 50 miles down the road at UC Irvine, and I am currently the chair of neurology. I finished my neurology training in 97. Until that time, I had not seen, although I'd heard of what we used to call at that time, Nonaka's myopathy. But I diagnosed my first patient when I went back to Pakistan, which is where I'm originally from, in 1998. And as you know, this disease is not only in the Persian Jewish communities, but is also very common in the South Asian population as well. In fact, when I came back in 2000 to Southern California, the first 9 patients I diagnosed were neither Jewish or Persian. We had a collection of South Asians, we had a collection of Caucasian as well as Korean patients as well. So this is a disease that's prevalent throughout the world, and it's an important disease to recognize because there are parts of the U.S. where folks in training never see this disease and never recognize this disease as well. As Lale mentioned, this is an incredibly exciting time for the NDF. We are really at a cross-section of very advanced biology and very advanced technology that is now available to understand the disease better, to be able to treat the disease better, and that has resulted in the current advances towards gene therapy. And as you know, gene therapy has become reality for some of the other neuromuscular conditions and some diseases like spinal muscular atrophy, which is a rare but fatal disease of infancy, can now potentially be called cured because of gene therapy. So we are hoping the same thing will happen with GNE, and I hope that this will happen. Now, because of this excitement, I get asked this question all the time in my practice, when is that gonna start? And there is naturally a sense of urgency that this treatment should happen and should happen tomorrow. The reality is, like anything that requires FDA supervision has to be done in stages. So the first stage of any treatment or anything that comes to final approval, the first step is the preclinical work, which has happened initially in animals and then in humans. And then you go to the FDA, which is the Federal Drug Authority, and you ask permission to do a conduct a trial in humans. So there is the preclinical work, there's the phase one work, there is phase two, and then phase three is the ultimate, what we call efficacy trial, where we show that a treatment is beneficial and actually does something on that. The NDF has already started the preclinical work, and through NDF's exclusive funding, preclinical work was done at Nationwide Children's Hospital by Professor Jerry Mendel, and we are now in the process of responding to some of the questions the FDA had raised about this work that was conducted in the phase one thing. I will have Ralph tell you more about the details of this and what's involved in this response process as well, because that is an important process as well. The goal is to then take this work as far as we can on an academic basis. So again, most drug companies or pharmaceutical companies do not get involved with the preclinical work or phase one work. They will take it on beyond that. So our goal, and I think this 2.5 million grant is the first step to provide funding for this additional work that needs to be done before some drug company will show interest in it. And as Lale mentioned, we are in a very lucky space that there are already 3 big companies that have shown interest in going forward with future work if we can show this work to be good. So we are in discussions with these companies. Ralph and I are both involved with these companies. And again, as I said, this is an incredibly exciting time, and I think things are moving really fast. And any support from you all is going to go a long way in making sure that this dream comes true. We are getting closer and closer to a gene therapy. And I would hand, so I want to congratulate NDF for this major initiative and the fantastic work in raising this work. And I will let Ralph tell you more about what's involved at this point. Thank you.
Thank you, Tishy. I'm Ralph Lauren. I'm a board member and the attorney for NDF. I have, my background is sort of scattered. I was a scientist, a patent lawyer, a patent litigator, a deal maker, and an entrepreneur in the biotech field. Basically, I want to give you some idea of what's going on and where we are. One of the things that's actually done, I can say tonight that we've actually started what's called whole genome sequencing. We've gotten a lot of samples from a number of people. We're now able to look at all the genes, not just the GNE gene, which is the one where the mutation is. And that for the different types of this disease, they're separate mutations, but all in the same gene. We now are looking to see whether there are modifiers or other things throughout the genome, because this is a slow progressing disease, as we all know. It doesn't start till someone's in their late teens, early 20s. And we're trying to figure out why it starts, why some people are faster or slower. So we're trying to get that information. That type of information is necessary to the FDA. They're really pushing to try to get this type of information. So we're doing the proper work to get just the best gene therapy we can get for people. And that is an important factor because the FDA is requiring a lot of testing. They're requiring natural history work. And we have natural history work that we've done and getting in information from NIH, Ultragenics, Newcastle, and various other places, trying to collect all this information now. I think that it's important that we look at this and say that what goes on here is, as Tashin said, there are several phases. We have to get through the clinical phase, the preclinical phase, and we have to get everything there. Once we get through that, we start phase one. Phase one is a safety trial. It's going to be small. There will be something like 6 patients in it. That's what was done in the pre-IND. It is only a 6 patient test, and that's about what the FDA is liking for these. Again, even that, it will be almost a month between patients when we get there before each one is injected. And there will be also like 3 people who will likely not get injected with the actual gene, but rather they'll get injected with a placebo. And we hate doing that, but you have to do it to show that it's really working. That's just the safety part. The next part of that is the phase 2 study. The phase 2 study is going to give us an idea of what the proper dosage is. And you try different doses to see what happens. And that will be a few more people, probably 12 people. At that stage, once we get through this, and each of these stages take months to do, figure 6 months to a year for each of the stages, once we actually get started. Then we get to a phase 3 with the efficacy trial. And that's going to take a longer time, more patients, but again, we're still talking a relatively low number of patients. We wish we could do everyone right away, but we have to get the best test for everyone, make sure it works, and try to find out how we can do it right. There's a molecular defect. We know there's a molecular defect. So we have to be able to see how we best cure that. And these studies, the FDA is putting out all sorts of things. Gene therapy is new. It's been worked. There are people working on it, but there's only one approved therapy in the United States right now, and that's for an eye disease. There are lots of them working, and they seem to be doing well. So we're trying. And we are having the funding we're going to get for this is going to allow this to go faster, better, and probably interest a company that's able to push it along. That's what our goal is now. We've talked to a number of companies, as we've said. We have a lot of interest going. This grant is going to help us to do that because they then can try to determine that this really works. This is the right gene, the right way of doing it. And that will help them. If they don't throw in the earliest money, we're throwing it in, but that will help them to do it. So far, we don't have all the information. That's what we're doing, this work. We have work doing on this whole genome sequencing at Yale, which I can say now we've actually started that. We have the first samples have been run. We have it going at PerkinElmer, and we've got work going from the NIH. All three organizations trying to work together to do this. Munkel Lek, who you just heard, is leading the fight at Yale. We're also trying to find markers. Biomarkers seem to be an important thing. The FDA is now saying, if you don't have a good animal model, and we don't have an animal model that really works very well, biomarkers are the next thing to use. We're working on that, and Angela, who you just saw, Angela Lek, is working on biomarkers for us. They also say that we want to get the work of others, we want to see what we've got. We're able to rely on the work that's happened now. There's been work by a number of the biotech companies in these neuromuscular diseases, as well as there's new work going on potentially ways of even recreating some muscle. We're helping to fund all that, we're trying to work on it, and we're trying to get the best thing to cure this disease. And I'm proud of the efforts we've done. I'm glad to be involved with this. But the bottom line is, please help us. This matching fund is important. It is going to be the thing that can potentially push this over the edge. So please be generous. Thank you.